Hello CIS scholars, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Scholars, as in our previous video, we already finished chapter 3 from our student's book, right? Have you finished reading? Okay, so today we are going to start new lesson that is very simple and very small lesson from our grammar textbook. Subchapter 3, Subject and Predicate. I hope you have studied this lesson earlier also in your previous class, in your standard 4th, right? So let's start. That is Subject and Predicate. Okay, scholars, what is subject and what is predicate? Before that, we already finished our second lesson in grammar, that is sentence and its types. So every sentence is made up of two parts, right? As every sentence is made up of two parts, means all sentences, whatever kind of sentences are there, all sentences are made up of two parts, right? What are that two parts? First, subject. In all sentences, there should be one subject. One part can be called as subject, and another part or the next part is predicate. Okay, now what is, and again, subject is divided into two parts. Okay, first is noun or noun phrase, not divided. We can say that in some sentence noun can be there and in some sentence noun phrase can be there. Okay, and how to recognize any subject, means how can we find out that in any sentence this word is subject? By asking question who or what, we can recognize subject of the sentence. Like, who are we talking about, means about whom we are talking, or about what we are talking. If we are asking such questions, the answer which we are getting, that answer can be called as subject. Okay, we will try to understand it with one example, right? Okay, so next is predicate. Predicate is also divided into two parts. It can be verb or verb phrase. Okay, it can be divided into verb or verb phrase, means in predicate or the part of sentence which is carrying verb or verb phrase can be called as predicate. The part of sentence which is carrying noun or noun phrase can be called as subject. Okay, is it clear to all? The part of sentence which is carrying subject can be called as, sorry, which is carrying noun or noun phrase can be called as subject. The part of sentence which is carrying verb or verb phrase can be called as predicate. How to recognize any subject in any sentence? By asking question who or what, the answer which we are getting can be called as subject. And how to recognize predicate in any sentence? By seeing the action or the word which is showing some action, so that part can be called as predicate. Okay, okay, now first we will see what is subject. The complete subject includes all the words that identifies the person or thing the sentence is about. Okay, the complete subject includes all the words, all the words that identifies the person or the thing the sentence is about, means not only single word will be subject. Okay, not only a single word will be the subject, group of word can be also the subject of the sentence. But the rule is that the group of word or the word which is identifying the person or thing of that sentence, then it can be called as subject. Let's see with one example. My Aunt Mary has a cat. My Aunt Mary has a cat. About whom we are talking, about who, about what we are talking about माय आंट मैरी. ओके, माय आंट मैरी इज सब्जेक्ट हियर. अबाउट व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग? अबाउट माय आंट मैरी, राइट? ओके, सो नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, टू फाइंड आउट प्रेडिकेट. हाउ टू फाइंड आउट प्रेडिकेट? What the subject is doing or what the subject is having. The subject is having a cat, means my aunt Mary has a cat. So here my aunt Mary is subject, has a cat is predicate. Okay, let's see one more example. The little old man walked with a cane. Okay, the little old man walked with a cane. Here walked is a verb. Okay, here in first sentence has is helping verb. Here walked is main verb. So walked is main verb, and we saw earlier that the predicate is carrying verb or verb phrase with it. So the part of sentence which is carrying verb can be called as predicate. So this part is predicate, walked with a cane. Okay, and subject, about whom we are talking? The little old man. About little old man we are talking. So the little old man is working here as a subject, and walked with a cane is working here as a predicate. Okay, it's clear? Okay, the simple subject is the main noun or pronoun. Subject can be noun or pronoun. If it is noun, then easy to find out name of place, person, thing. Okay, if it is pronoun, then also it's very easy to find out, because we all know what is pronoun very well. Okay, the word which can be used in place of noun can be called as pronoun. Let's see with one example. The boy with the blue shirt waved to me. The boy with the blue shirt waved to me. Okay, waved is verb, right? Who waved? The boy. Means about whom we are talking here? About the boy. About the boy we are talking. So the boy is subject here. With the blue shirt waved to me, the whole part can be called as predicate. Except subject, the remaining part of the sentence can be called as predicate. You have to remember this. Except subject, you have to recognize subject, right? First you have to recognize subject. After recognizing subject, the rest part of the sentence can be called as predicate. Okay, let's see one more example. Jack loves to play saucer. Okay, Jack loves to play saucer. So who loves to play? Jack. Jack, who means Jack. So Jack is subject here. Loves to play saucer. Loves to play saucer, verb is here. So this part is can be called as predicate. Okay, see what is predicate. The complete predicate indicates all words that tell what the subject of the sentence is or does. I told you that the rest part, after recognizing subject, the rest part of the sentence tells us about the subject, and that part can be called as predicate. Okay, for example, Tom took 3 marbles from the pile. Tom took 3 marbles from the pile. Who took? Tom took. So Tom is subject here. Took means verb. Took 3 marbles from the pile. What subject is doing? Subject is taking 3 marbles. So Tom took 3 marbles from the pile. Here Tom is subject, and took 3 marbles from the pile is predicate. Okay, okay, next is the simple predicate is the main verb or the verb phrase. I told you in starting when I showed that tree diagram, there I showed that predicate can carry verb or verb phrase. There can be main verb or verb phrase. So the simple predicate is the main verb or the verb phrase. For example, a quick coyote caught a lizard. A quick coyote caught a lizard. What is verb here? What is verb here? Caught. Okay, इट मीन्स द पार्ट विच इज कैरिंग वर्ब और वर्ब फ्रेज कैन बी कॉल्ड एज प्रेडिकेट. सो हियर दिस पार्ट इज कैरिंग वर्ब. सो दिस पार्ट कैन बी कॉल्ड एज प्रेडिकेट. अ क्विक क्वाइट कॉट अ लिजर्ड. ओके, वेरी सिंपल लेसन इट इज. एज आई टोल्ड यू इन स्टार्टिंग, मैच द कॉलम. हियर यू हैव टू मैच द कॉलम. इन कॉलम ए वॉट इज गिवन इन कॉलम ए सब्जेक्ट एंड इन कॉलम बी वॉट इज गिवन प्रेडिकेट. यू हैव टू मैच दिस टू कॉलम. फर्स्ट वन इज ऑलरेडी डन फॉर यू. नेक्स्ट वी विल ट्राई. द डॉग इज चूइंग ऑन बोन. द डॉग इज चूइंग ऑन अ बोन. ओके, यू आर गोइंग अलोन टू स्कूल टूडे. द कैट रैन अप द ट्री. ओके, दिस फोर आई टोल्ड. द रेस्ट टू यू हैव टू डू बाय योरसेल्फ. ओके, सिंपल इट इज. व्हाई आई टोल्ड यू फोर, बिकॉज आवर नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज मीन्स एक्सरसाइज बी इज रिलेटेड विथ एक्सरसाइज ए. ओके, सो आई टोल्ड यू हियर फोर आंसर्स एंड रेस्ट टू यू हैव टू डू बाय योरसेल्फ. वेरी सिंपल. आई नो यू ऑल आर वेरी स्मार्ट एंड यू कैन डू इट बाय योरसेल्फ. ओके, सो फर्स्ट हियर इन नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू राइट ऑल दिस सेंटेंसेस. यू हैव टू री राइट ऑल दिस सेंटेंसेस. वॉट एवर यू हैव मैच्ड हियर सब्जेक्ट एंड प्रेडिकेट, यू हैव टू री राइट दिस सेंटेंस लाइक हियर इट्स डन. आई एम गोइंग टू द प्ले ग्राउंड. ओके, फर्स्ट वन इज रिटन हियर. आई एम गोइंग टू द प्ले ग्राउंड. फर्स्ट सेंटेंस इज रिटन हियर. इन द सेम वे यू हैव टू राइट ऑल सेंटेंसेस. ओके, सो वॉट यू हैव टू डू इन नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज, आफ्टर राइटिंग दिस सेंटेंस, आफ्टर री राइटिंग दिस ऑल सेंटेंसेस, यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट यू सब्जेक्ट एंड आफ्टर सब्जेक्ट यू हैव टू पुट स्लैश मार्क. लाइक हियर आई एम गोइंग टू द प्ले ग्राउंड. सो आफ्टर आई वी हैव टू पुट स्लैश मार्क. ओके, बिकॉज आई इज सब्जेक्ट, एम गोइंग टू द प्ले ग्राउंड इज प्रेडिकेट. वाई? बिकॉज इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस इज कैरिंग वर्ब एंड हेल्पिंग वर्ब विथ इट सेल्फ. सो दिस पार्ट कैन बी कॉल्ड एज प्रेडिकेट. एंड आई इज सब्जेक्ट. वाई इट इज सब्जेक्ट? बिकॉज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट वॉट? वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट आई. सो आई इज सब्जेक्ट. आफ्टर आई यू हैव टू पुट स्लैश मार्क इन बी एक्सरसाइज. नाउ सी एक्सरसाइज, सेम यू हैव टू डू. सेंटेंसेस आर गिवन, यू हैव टू पुट स्लैश मार्क आफ्टर सब्जेक्ट. हाउ यू विल पुट स्लैश मार्क? यू हैव टू रिकॉग्नाइज फर्स्ट सब्जेक्ट, मीन्स अबाउट वॉट और अबाउट हु वी आर टॉकिंग. जीतू एट टू मेनी स्वीट्स टूडे. हु एट टू मेनी स्वीट्स? हु एट जीतू, राइट? सो जीतू इज वर्किंग हियर एज सब्जेक्ट. वी हैव टू पुट स्लैश मार्क आफ्टर जीतू, राइट? द नेक्स्ट इज द नर्स गेव जेरी एन इंजेक्शन. ओ नो, फॉर जेरी इट्स वेरी बैड. ओके, हु गेव इन एन इंजेक्शन? हु गेव इंजेक्शन टू जेरी? द नर्स. सो द नर्स इज वर्किंग हियर एज सब्जेक्ट. द नर्स गेव जेरी एन इंजेक्शन. सो यू हैव टू पुट स्लैश मार्क आफ्टर सब्जेक्ट, आफ्टर द नर्स. इन द सेम वे यू हैव टू सॉल्व रेस्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस. सो नाउ इन डी एक्सरसाइज, राइट सुइटेबल प्रेडिकेट्स फॉर द सब्जेक्ट्स गिवन बिलो. You have to put by yourself. Very interesting it is. You can frame sentence by yourself, right? The subject part is given. You have to add only predicate part. So the young girl is dancing gracefully. I wrote this. You can write by yourself also. The young girl is dancing gracefully. Dancing means verb it is. All the monkeys in the zoo are swinging on the trees. Obviously, monkeys are doing this work, right? So I wrote this. You can write by yourself something else. And rest of the sentence, you have to make or you have to frame this all sentence by yourself by adding predicate in this. So next, last exercise, complete the sentences by writing suitable subject for the predicates given below. Here, you already have predicates and you have to add subject here. Simple it is, right? Dash live in Mumbai. Who? I can also live in Mumbai, right? So I wrote here, the children live in Mumbai. by because leave word is showing that it is it here leave means it is used for plural. So the children means plural. The children live in Mumbai. Next is dash grew in the orchard behind my grandfather's house. Who grew the lamb? The lamb grew in the orchard behind my grandfather's house. So in the same way you have to add subject in all of the sentence. What you have to do, predicate is already written, you have to add only subject. So scholars, you have to listen this video, you have to see this video again and again, so you can solve all the exercise and all the sentences by yourself, because this is very simple lesson and very easy to understand. Only subject and predicate. Subject by asking who and what, and predicate by watching carefully verb part. Okay, so try to do it by yourself. Take care. Bye bye.